Dear students, greetings to all. In this module, we will be continuing with our ongoing chapter, Chapter 7, Structural Organization in Animals of Biology. In this module, we will be discussing about the second tissue in animals, that is the connective tissue. As the name indicates, connective tissue links and supports other tissues and organs of the body. Talking about the connective tissue, it is the most abundant and widely distributed tissue in the body of complex animals. The connective tissue are composed of cells, fibers, and matrix. That's the ground substance. These cells are loosely arranged or widely separated from each other by extracellular material that is called the matrix. So matrix is basically composed of polysaccharides, that's glycoprotein, and is secreted by the tissue cells. The fibers which are present, they are basically of two types, collagen, white fibers, and the yellow elastin fibers, which are secreted by the tissue cells. The fibers provide tensile strength, elasticity, and flexibility to the tissue. Talking about the classification of the connective tissue, the connective tissue is classified basically into loose, dense regular, and specialized connective tissue. The loose connective tissue comprises of areolar tissue and adipose tissue. The dense connective tissue comprises of dense regular and dense irregular tissue. The specialized connective tissue comprises of cartilage, bones, and blood. Talking about the first connective tissue, that is the loose connective tissue. Now, the characteristics of loose connective tissue are that it has many cells and fibers which are loosely arranged in a semi-fluid ground substance or matrix. It is of two types, the areolar tissue and the adipose tissue. In this, the cells basically, that is the fibroblast cells, which produce and secrete the fibers, the macrophages and mast cells, which are basically involved in phagocytosis, they are present in a semi-fluid matrix. Now, these are the underlying diagrams of the areolar tissue and the adipose tissue. Firstly, the areolar loose connective tissue. It is present beneath the skin. We can see through the diagrammatic representation that these cells, that is the macrophages, the mast cells, which carry out phagocytosis, have been marked. Fibroblasts are the cells that produce and secrete fibers. So there is presence of dense collagen fibers and the elastin fibers. It gives support framework for the epithelium, and it consists of three types of cells, the fibroblast cells, the macrophages, and the mast cells. Talking about the next loose connective tissue, that is the adipose tissue. It is present beneath the skin. The cells are called as adipocytes, which store the fat, and it also helps in shock absorption, and the other function of the adipose tissue is to carry out storage. So we can see that there's a fat storage area in the underlying diagram. The adipocytes have got their own nucleus and a prominent plasma membrane. So the cells, they are basically oval in shape. They are present beneath the skin. They are present in the eyeballs, and they play a vital role in shock absorption. The dense connective tissue, it consists of fibers and fibroblasts which are compactly packed. They are basically divided into two types, the dense regular connective tissue and the dense irregular connective tissue. So in this module, we have started up with the connective tissue, the introductory part related to connective tissue, and we talked about the classification of the connective tissue, dealt with the first, that is the loose connective tissue. Hopefully, you must have garnered all the concepts thoroughly. Thank you.